Joining us now is Alonzo Washington with CASA in Action. Alonzo, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So your organization helps in reaching Latino, immigrant, and working class voters. Now that you're looking back on everything that you did, what were some of your challenges before Election Day?
You know, I would like to say thank you to everybody out there who went out to vote in this upcoming election. There were so many hardships placed in our path for Black and brown voters, for Latino, immigrant, and indigenous people to be able to vote in this upcoming election. And we're just so proud that our people came out and showed out in this upcoming election. We've mobilized over 1.2 million voters here at CASA in Action, and this work doesn't stop now. We're going to continue to work after this election as well.
Yeah, and then we had the protest in Philly in the spring, and then more recently, what did that do to your effort to reach out to people?
We continue to knock on doors. We didn't stop. Yeah. Our folks kept on continuing to knock on doors, reach out to people constantly every day. Black and brown people have mobilized and are winning this election for Joe Biden. But this isn't about him. This is about us and our communities and our people and Black and brown women who actually went out and voted and made sure that we won this election in Philly and in Harrisburg as well. So and throughout the state of Pennsylvania. So we have a lot to thank for those Black women and for those Latino women that went out and voted for the Democrats this year.
Yeah, one more piece of the puzzle for your team, doing with all the challenges, plus add in a pandemic. So that had to be a little bit challenging.
That was challenging. You know, yeah. Because there was so much misinformation out there from this administration, people were weary. But we went out and knocked on doors and informed our voters and informed Black and brown voters who otherwise wouldn't have went out to the polls and let them know that there's options out there for them to actually vote. And we weren't going to allow COVID-19 nor this administration ruin our chances for making sure that we remove Trump from office. That was our goal. And we educated all of our voters to make sure they went out to the polls.
Your organization was aligned with our organization in that this whole time we have been fighting misinformation and people's fears because of misinformation. What kinds of things were you hearing from people, and what kinds of issues and information did you have to say, this is true and this is not true?
Yeah, you know, it was a lot of things that went out there that folks just felt like it wasn't enough information for them to be able to go to the polls. They weren't sure where their polling places were. They weren't sure where to drop off their ballots. So we educated and informed voters and Black and brown people around the state to make sure they knew where they can actually vote. And they did just that. And so we're so proud of them. We're so proud of our community that they got out and turned out in record numbers. In the state of Pennsylvania, turned out like no other, the most numbers we've ever seen. So we're so proud of everybody for getting up and getting out during this pandemic.
After all that you've done and all the work that you've done, what's going through your mind today as we all sort of keep our eyes on the Pennsylvania Convention Center and the demonstrators on both sides and the volunteers who have been who deserve the applause that the city leaders today were saying, thank you for all these volunteers who've worked so hard to count them. What's going through your mind?
Look, we want to thank our elections officials. We know some of them are volunteering. Others are doing this during a pandemic. But we know that they're there to make sure every vote counts. And they count every vote. So every vote must be counted and every vote must count. And I'm proud that we have a democracy here in our country to make sure that every vote does count, because that's what's on our minds every day, to make sure that no voter is disenfranchised. And we're not going to allow that to happen, and we're not going to sit idly by. So that's why we're going to continue to fight. It doesn't end today. It doesn't end tomorrow. We're going to continue to fight in Pennsylvania to make sure that every vote does count. So we're gonna do everything we can to make sure that every vote counts.
Every vote counts. Every voice is heard. Alonzo Washington with CASA in Action. Thank you so much, Alonzo. We appreciate you being with us today.
No, thank you for having me.